Iran Barkley, he says he's fighting for some respect from Roberto Duran. He's also fighting to defend his final title the first time. There is the blade. He beat Tommy Hearns for the crown. Now he says he's going to beat another legend to keep it. Roberto Duran in at a very svelte 156 pounds. His 19th title match of various assortments in various weight divisions. The tail of the tape, Gil, we take a look at the fact that Iran Barkley, much taller and a big reach, but he doesn't fight like a fighter that way.
Well, the thing is that Roberto Duran can take advantage of the fact that he's the shorter guy. In and out, get inside, get underneath Barkley's punches, throw the combinations and get back out.
All right, let's take a look at the WBC rules. They will change a bit for this fight. 10-point scoring system. The fight is scored by three judges. Three knockdown rule in effect. That is the same as the New Jersey. They adopted it. No standing eight count. Fighter cannot be saved by the bell, even in the last round, and only the referee can stop this fight. We're ready. The WBC Middleweight Championship. Iran Barkley and Roberto Duran. Let's go to Michael.
Ladies and gentlemen, would everyone please rise for the national anthem of Panama? Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing as our Star Spangled Banner will be sung by Miss Barbara Kay. Ladies and gentlemen, from Convention Hall, by way of Donald J. Trump's Trump Plaza Hotel and Casino, Top Rank and HBA present professional championship boxing. This bout is sanctioned by the New Jersey State Athletic Control Board, Boxing Commissioner Larry Hazard, Deputy Commissioners Nick D. Balestrieri and Lawrence Wallace. The chairman is Jerry Gormley. Chief Physician at ringside, Dr. Frank B. Doggett. Also at ringside, Dr. Charles Wilson, Dr. Dominic Coletta. The timekeeper, Lindsay Tucker. Counting for the knockdown seconds, Steve Smoger. Representing the World Boxing Council at ringside, Mr. John Prescott from Canada. He is the supervisor. The three judges appointed by the WBC. Tommy Kaczmarek of the United States, Giuseppe Ferrari from Italy, and Dave Brown from Canada. And now, ladies and gentlemen, from the Trump Plaza Hotel and Casino, let's get ready to rumble! 12 rounds for the WBC Middleweight Championship of the World. The referee for this bout is Joe Cortez. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, he's wearing the black trunks with gold letters and weighs 156 and one quarter pounds. He's from Panama City in Panama. As a professional, he's 84 and 7, 61 KOs. He's the former lightweight champion of the world, the former welterweight champion of the world, the former junior middleweight champion of the world. Señores y señoras, los manos de piedras, Roberto Duran! And fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the black trunks with red trim, he weighs an even 159 pounds. He's from the Bronx in New York City. His professional record, 25 and 4, 16 KOs. He won the championship with a sensational knockout of Thomas the Hitman Hearns. Ladies and gentlemen, the WBC middleweight champion of the world, Iran, the Blade, Barkley!
When I say break, give me a clean break, but you go break, me don't break limpio, okay? Ya saben, es la regla dentro, o siempre escucha mi commands, okay? Give me check, hands out, good luck. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Hey, come on, I ran, come on. Come on, shake hands, come on, let's shake hands. Let's go, let's go. All right, let's go.
And so the stage is set. It's not a seat to be had in this convention hall. And everybody pumped up to see that man, Roberto Duran, try and win his fourth title and to see if Iran, the Blade Barkley, can defend his WBC crown the first time. And Gil, we expect Barkley to be very aggressive early, and it looks like he is.
And Roberto Duran is gonna have to make Barkley miss and counter and move to the side the way he just did then. In and out, throw his combinations and get out of there. Maybe easier said than done.
Iran Barkley at 28 has never been thought of as a great ring technician, but he probably has better skills than people are willing to give him credit for. He certainly has power, and that's what he hopes will be useful to him tonight against Duran, a man who, after all, still is coming up from 135 pounds when he started.
Two good left hooks by Barkley. And you have to remember, Al, that the Roberto Duran hands of stone has never shown that much power as a middleweight up to this point. Great defensive fighter. There's those combinations right there.
Well, the feeling is that this will be a war however long it lasts, and it's giving some indications already of being that. I don't think Iran Barkley's ever been in a fight that wasn't entertaining. Barkley using the jab, and there's that left hook to the body. He has got a good left hook downstairs.
There's that counter bite. Roberto Duran, make the other guy miss and counter. And you know, Al, they say there's so much bad blood between these two guys. I'd still wager that no matter how the fight ends, that they're gonna shake hands and probably hug each other when the fight's over. Well, you gain respect during a fight.
I'm not so sure I agree with you on that. Maybe that will happen, but we'll see.
Well, let's wait and see.
All right. Iran Barkley, of course, we've chronicled how he feels his friend Davey Moore took the beating at the hands of Duran. In that fight, Duran thumbed Moore. There were a lot of illegal tactics.
Nice move by Barkley that time.
Iran showing us a couple of things in his first round that people don't always give him credit for. An excellent jab, and as you say, some good movement as well. And he's going to the body. You said earlier today when we were talking, you thought Iran Barkley should test the body of Duran, and he's starting to do that.
Well, as I said, if I was training Iran Barkley, he'd be throwing punches at nothing but that body. The head would take care of itself, because Roberto was too slick, just too slick to hit on a head.
Duran lands the right, is knocked off balance. Whether he was hurt, we don't know. It's a 20-foot ring, but they're not using much of it. Barkley, the 28-year-old from the Bronx, who beat Thomas. Oh, big right hand staggers Barkley.
Barkley is hurt. He is hurt. No question about that. We mentioned the fact that Duran has not shown punching powers in middleweight. There it was.
A big right hand.
Slips the punch, right hand right over that left hand of Barkley. What a beautiful move. That's what he said he has to do. He has to make Barkley miss and then counter punch.
How many reincarnations can this man have as a pro, and are we seeing another one tonight? It's too early to tell, especially against Iran Barkley, who we've seen come get off the deck to beat people.
Barkley has a way of coming back. I mean, he's just a warrior. No question about that. But he can't get nailed with too many of those punches, Al.
Roberto Duran, he's 37 years old. Barkley trying to hang on to his WBC middleweight title. He felt the power of Duran in the first round, and in round two.
We talked about the emotion of Barkley, how he wanted to get even for his friend Avery Moore, but he is fighting a controlled fight, Al. He's not going wild, moving in behind the jab.
It's a very good point, Gil, and a little different of the first round than we thought we'd see from Barkley. He left one of those jabs out there, and that's why Duran nailed him with the overhand right.
But Duran has to make Barkley miss and then take advantage of every opportunity.
Since Duran lost to Sugar Ray Leonard in 1980, his total record is 12-7, so he has not been real effective in a lot of big title matches in recent years. But he's off to a good start in this one. Good right hand by Barkley, but it does not move Duran back. This one will be warfare.
Good body punches by Barkley, and there's another one. Little short left hook by Roberto.
You can see the fire of Iran Barkley coming out now, but Duran not backing up. Terrific body shots by Barkley. My, is he going downstairs well. Halfway through round two, and this fight is all that it was billed as. Duran going downstairs.
Barkley's landing those body shots every time he gets a chance. He drops one down on that body.
So far, that's probably the major story other than the right hand by Duran, because in a couple of rounds, those body shots would take a big toll on the 37-year-old body of Duran, no matter what his weight.
Duran is looking to throw that right hand over that left hand of Barkley's again, though.
And you know what? Iran Barkley doing a better job of covering up on the inside than some people are used to seeing from him. Using his strength to push Duran back. Excellent uppercut by Barkley. Overhand right, but the left hook gets there by Duran. And a right hand by Roberto.
Took a lot of body punishment this round, though, Al.
It's been a good round for Barkley to this point, though Duran is landing his share also right now. Barkley slips the right hand.
Duran's mouth is now wide open. It's only the second round now.
It is scheduled for 12, but at this pace, could it go that long? Joe Cortez looking very carefully in to make sure. Well, that'll do it for round two. A good one for Barkley. We follow the hands of Stone back. He does look a bit tired.
What a compliment.
He's
respira tranquilo, respira. Normal, normal. Respira, normal. Guarda, guarda, então. Respira, normal.
As you look at this man, he came here, Gil, obviously, to make turn this into a war, feeling that was his best shot.
He has to stay to the side, side to side, and move inside Barkley's punches, counter, and then get back out. You can't trade power for power with Iran Barkley. Those body punches are going to take too much out of him.
These Roberto Duran fans, they're never say die people. They remember very well in Madison Square Garden when they filled it with this man's debut war, his last really grand moment of glory. He's trying to rekindle it against one of Davey's best friends. Of course, Davey Moore, no longer with us, died in a car accident. And this man, Iran Barkley, is dedicated to fight to his friend's memory. Right now, it's only him, though, against Duran as we head into the third. Barkley's body attack has been superb. And he's also shown us an excellent jab.
And he doubles up that jab.
Well, it's in vogue to denigrate the boxing skills of Iran Barkley. We talk mostly about his power and his courage, but he's showing us more of the boxing skills tonight.
And you can also watch Barkley do a stutter step with his feet. He's feinting with his feet. There's that right hand again. But Barkley answered with a good short left.
Barkley's been on the mat before. Michael Lajide had him there. He lost to Robbie Sims by knockout in a wild affair. And Hearns certainly punished him, but he comes back when he's hurt. And you see it here.
And you know, you mentioned Robbie Sims. I did the fight with Duran and Robbie Sims, and a split decision. It was just such a tough fight for Duran to lose.
Interestingly, that is their common opponent, and they both lost to Robbie Sims, even though Robbie has never found his way to a world title.
You know, I just detected something, and they shouted to Barkley, who was going to watch the right hand, because I could see Roberto trying to set him up, lull him to sleep, and then drop that right hand over his jab.
We're halfway through round three, a round in which the pace has slowed just a bit, but not much. And it needed to, for both fighters' sake.
Good jab by Roberto Duran.
Probably his best jab of the fight so far.
What a man this Roberto Duran is.
He's in against a guy who physically is much stronger than him.
You know, even against the big middleweight, Barkley just looks so big. He looks like a light heavyweight.
He really does. And that power has helped him in most middleweight fights. Master boxer Sambu Kalambay thwarted his efforts to win a title before.
Body shots again by Barkley.
But right now, the body work, as you said, of Barkley, a real important weapon. That right did not even stop Duran. It landed perfectly. The real power of Barkley is probably in his left hook, although Tommy Hearns was nailed with a big right. Round three just about over. It's been an excellent round for Iran Barkley. Counter right over a lazy jab by Barkley, but he smiles at Roberto Duran. Some gamesmanship from the champion from South Bronx.
Okay, how you feel? Good.
We follow him back in. That's Al Bolden talking to him.
Work that body. Keep him working. Keep him backing up.
Do your job. Do your job.
There you go. Keep putting that jab out on him, working that body. Him with them shots. He's trying to use that right hand to the head. Try to sleep. Get the right hand to your head, okay? Get them hands up and work that jab. Step in with the jab. Double it up. One, two, quick one, two every now and then.
Look at the end of the round in which Barkley had some excellent moments on the inside. And there's that right over the lazy jab of Barkley.
Hey, Duran is so smart. He just looks to lull him to sleep, and then boom, he explodes. That's what he has to do. Fight in flurries, score points when he can.
We're heading into round four. The eyes of Roberto Duran. There's a sinister look there, even now. And Duran comes out wailing away to the body in the fourth round. Good hook by Barkley. Gil, you talked about what a controlled fight Barkley is fighting, much more so than I think anyone anticipated from him.
Yes, he seems to really, you know, I've always said that once a guy becomes champion of the world, it automatically makes him like a 25% fighter. And I guess maybe they feel good, whatever it is, and he has good coaching, but he is a much improved fighter in this fight.
He looks better, period. And we've talked at length about...
Very low.
Duran complains to Joe Cortez.
And rightly so.
Who says lift him up, and it was rightly so. But I'm sure Iran Barkley's thinking to himself, he's complaining? Duran, the master of some extracurricular activities. But I'll tell you, Iran Barkley is committed to that body work, and it is really paying dividends for him so far in this bout.
Duran is going to have to use that right hand a little more.
Barkley pushing him off. Oh, my. Combinations on the inside by both men. The right
hand
again.
Right hand again, and Barkley wobbled a little bit then.
That right hand hurt Iran Barkley, but when you hurt him, he seems to be more dangerous. It's been his track record. What a war. Uppercut on the inside by Barkley.
Those are those short little combinations that Duran has to throw, but then he has to spin out and get out of there. He can't wait for the receipt.
Iran Barkley has followed his game plan perfectly, and yet Duran, very competitive because he's so clever, throwing those counter right hands. We talked about the cuts, nothing like that developing over the eyes of Iran Barkley. He's got to be very heartened by that at this point.
I wouldn't like to see either fighter get cut, Al.
No, and it's very good because there was the concern over Barkley cutting.
Al, this could be the round. It could be the big turning point in the fight because they're just staying there. Mano a mano, I guess.
Oh, what a right by Duran. They are both landing big shots. Who will go? Duran is now stunned. And this was later in the round when Duran had his moments.
You know, they talk about Duran having hands of stone. He's got a chin of stone. He's got to hit some good shots right on the button.
Come on, let's go. Check it out. Come on, let's go.
Boy, it must seem like deja vu to Iran Barkley. Here he is in a terrific war. He's from New York. We're in New Jersey. And what is this crowd yelling? Duran, Duran. Just like when Davey Moore fought in his hometown against Duran. We're into round five, and if there is any discouragement on the part of Barkley because of that, I doubt that it'll show. He is a very courageous and tough performer. It's been four rounds of nonstop action. Remember, Duran landed a big right in the second that seemed to hurt Barkley. Barkley did great body work in the first and the third and in the fourth, but Duran came back with some good shots toward the end of that fourth round.
Well, that was a tough round to score, huh?
Was it ever?
You really had to be alert because Duran landed some beautiful short combinations. But in the meanwhile, Barkley worked the entire 3 minutes.
Early in the round, Barkley very effective, and then perhaps in the last minute, Duran with the edge. Scheduled for 12 for the WBC Middleweight Championship that now rests with Iran Barkley. Duran seeking his fourth world title.
Big right hand by Barkley, And it did not faze Roberto Duran.
And it was followed by an excellent uppercut. Iran Barkley is landing major league punches and Duran's going nowhere. And now Duran countering well.
Two solid right hands by Duran. You know, this fight may wind up being who's the better catcher, not who's the better pitcher.
They're both pitching and they're both catching. Great body shot by Barkley. A strong jab by Iran Barkley. Everything's landing now, just about. That's the difference between Duran now and maybe 8 years ago. He never would have been hit with this many punches, but he's taking them. See the sneer from Duran.
I just don't believe this man.
It's astonishing he's taking these punches from Barkley because, let me tell you folks, Iran Barkley is a good middleweight puncher. No, he's an excellent middleweight puncher. Big right on the inside by Barkley.
Good combination, a left hook, right hand. And Roberto, as you say, is quick, doing a lot of catching, but he hasn't been bothered.
Ironically, Barkley is probably following their game plan to a T, and yet Duran is still there. I'm sure they thought if he did all this, Duran would fold. We're in round five, and it's been fought at a torrid pace right from the first round. Duran going to the body. As we conclude round five again, the crowd picks up the chant of Duran's name. Big right by Duran. Another one goes in the books, and I mean an outstanding round.
Keep the jab moving inside. You got me?
Come on. There may be a cut over one of Iran Barkley's eyes. We'll take a peek and see if we can find it. Yes, Ed Aliano, very fine cut man, will work on it.
Get back in the fight, okay? Come on, you got to keep working with that jab now. Work that jab and work that body. Don't let him rest. Don't let him rest. Don't set up that pose with him. Keep popping it. Okay. We're going one, 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 back. Okay, take a deep breath. Come on now, you can't sit down and go to sleep and let him get back in the ball game. Okay? Mm-hmm. You got to keep working. Keep that pressure. Long the fight, go the best for you. Okay? You got to keep working him, though. You got me?
Okay,
fine. Okay. Come on now. Take a deep breath. Let's go. Go back with that jab.
Control the fight. Control.
We're headed for the sixth, nearing the halfway point in this middleweight championship match. Roberto Duran standing in there against Iran Barkley.
You know, Al, I noticed at the end of the round that Duran looked in a little better shape than Iran Barkley. Barkley was starting to show a little signs of being tired.
I think you're right, Gil. And Al Bolden pumping up Iran Barkley, saying the longer the fight goes, the better it is for us. But that may not necessarily be the case, though you would have thought that coming in. We're in the sixth. Iran Barkley on the right of your screen and Roberto Duran on the left, and if you didn't know that, you've been in a time capsule for the last 20 years. It's likely that Barkley is ahead on the scoring. I would think he is, and yet Roberto Duran's had some very fine moments in this bout.
And you see, what Barkley's been doing is working the entire 3 minutes. And Roberto is throwing beautiful, showy combinations, but not enough of them, in my opinion.
The judges, we might remind you, Tommy Kaczmarek from the U.S., Giuseppe Ferrari from Italy, and Dave Brown from Canada.
But Barkley works and works.
He's been the more active of the two, which is not to suggest that Duran hasn't been active. This may be the most punches Duran has thrown in the fight in years.
You know, Al, I just can't believe that this is the same guy that won the lightweight championship of the world for my fighter, Kenny Buchanan, in 1972.
Long now term.
Good left hook by Roberto Duran. And now he's fighting for the middleweight championship.
In 1989. And along the way, boy, there have been some ups and downs for him. And of course, he fluctuates in weight so badly. Back in October, Roberto Duran may have weighed as much as 190 pounds. And look at him now, he's 156, obviously in great fighting shape, and battling on fairly even terms with Barkley.
You know, I talked to him right after his fight with the marvelous Marvin Hagler, and it was a very, very close fight after 12 rounds. And he told me, he says, I just got tired in those last couple of rounds. And the same thing happened to him with Robbie Sims. But now he seems to be in better condition. He's a little lighter. I just don't know if he can keep this pace up for an entire 12-round fight.
And, of course, the question of all that body punching that Barkley has done, what effect will it have as we head into the later rounds? This round, probably the slowest of the fight, even though there's still been a lot of offense shown.
Barkley, this round has been all Barkley up to this point, though, Al.
Yeah, he's throwing more combinations, working the body, still using that jab effectively. And so if we thought he was tired after the last round, he's shown us a second wind here. And now Duran pushing his punches a little bit. Barkley digging to the body as he has been throughout this bout. That'll do it for round six. Roberto Duran finds his corner and will go in there where on occasion there's been some chaotic action in the Duran corner. Relative calm. Gil, how important at this point is it for Duran to get inside the jab of Barkley? That jab is really doing well for him.
You know, Al, they say that the hardest punch you can hit another fighter is with is when you make him miss. What Duran has to do is make Barkley miss and nail him coming in. He's going to have to nail Barkley with some big punches to get himself back in this fight.
Iran Barkley comes out for round seven. You see the substance over his left eye. There looked like maybe there was a minor cut there, but it hasn't developed into anything. And Ed Aliano, who of course is known as one of the best cut men in the business, Percy Richardson, one of the other great cut men also here tonight, working with some of the Olympians, did a good job of closing it. Round seven action, set for 12. The WBC Middleweight Championship, the champion Iran Barkley ripping.
Good left hook by Roberto Duran.
Duran landing on the inside, so is Barkley. And if they took a little time off in the sixth, although Barkley certainly didn't, Duran came out hard here in the seventh. Could this be his last stand in this bout?
He's so smart, though, inside. Barkley just fires, but Duran knows what he's doing. He moves around.
What a hook by Barkley.
And a good right hand by Duran.
The fact that Barkley is cranking up those hooks and landing like that, and Duran is not being staggered, really is amazing.
Well, as I say, this may wind up being the guy who can catch better.
The crowd starts to chant again. Even if it's not a home crowd for Duran when it starts, like Ali and some of the other greats like Sugar Ray Leonard, it always ends up being a home crowd for him. Barkley using the uppercut, that's been a real good weapon for him.
Duran slipped six consecutive punches that time. Just what beautiful boxing.
He's a master at defense, that's always been one of his trademarks. Excellent right hand. That one stunned Barkley, I think.
Barkley answered with a vicious left hook to the body, and Duran came back. He's nailing Barkley with some big punches now, Al.
What an uppercut by Barkley after Duran hit him with big shots. Nothing is phasing Roberto Duran. What a double left hook by Barkley. Duran holding on.
He's hurt, Al. That first time in a fight, he's really hurt.
Can he weather this storm? Duran is hurt. He was hurt with two left hooks. Seven has been a classic.
Just about every round in this fight has been a classic.
That's true. Crowd trying to pump up Duran. How much is left in that 37-year-old body? That's what Iran Barkley's wondering.
He's blowing now, Barkley.
Why not? Oh, right hand again by Duran over a very lazy jab by Barkley. Nothing comes easy to Iran Barkley, and it's not coming easy tonight.
Watch your hands inside.
Right misses by Barkley. Three straight left hooks by Barkley. Two to the body and one to the head. And Duran still responds. They stare at each other after the seventh round.
Let's take a look now. Ooh, two left hooks right on the button. But Duran did not move.
And he finished with the right. Now Roberto Duran has his moment in that last round. The counter right over that low left hand has been so effective.
Well, that's what Duran has to do. He has to nail him with those big punches.
All right, second shot.
Well, he has to say to himself, what's keeping this guy up? I mean, he's hit him with some vicious punches.
Iran Barkley, 16 KOs among his 25 wins, and he's knocked out some good people, including Michael Lajide and Tommy Hearns.
And his manager just told him, he says, Barkley, you're in a fight. I don't think he has to be reminded of that.
I'm fairly certain Iran Barkley knew that.
You know, one of the things I liked about Barkley at the end of the last round, as big a war as the round was, at the very end of the round, Barkley still had his composure, still using that left jab.
It's been a more disciplined effort by Barkley. And it's a good thing for him it has, because otherwise he would have been getting hit with a lot more. Good short left hook by Barkley. From the left hook.
Everything but his heart is in trouble, Al. Look at this Duran fire back.
Can Barkley take him out? Duran doing a wonderful job of tying him up on the inside and slipping punches and landing his own uppercut.
See, he's so smart, Al. He knows inside he's protecting himself, relaxing, trying to clear his head.
If there is a smarter fighter around than Roberto Duran, it would be unlikely. Barkley left hook has been such a good weapon the last two rounds, and that one really stunned Duran, but Roberto is surviving so far.
You know, I just never count Roberto Duran out, but it looks to me like he's pushing his punches now, Al.
He's lost something, that's for sure. Again, the hook by Barkley.
But a nice move before the hook. Stepped over to the right, came back with the hook. Barkley's shown me a lot of improvement as a fighter tonight. Win or lose.
Perhaps Iran Barkley's best effort, you could make the case.
I would absolutely have to say so.
Against an obviously rejuvenated Duran.
And Barkley made Duran miss that time and then nailed Duran with the left hook.
Good body work by Barkley. He is remembering his game plan. Keeping his poise and still doing the things that have made him effective in this bout.
Then a little step over to the right out. There it is again by Barkley. Getting an angle on Roberto.
Big right by Barkley, but Duran lands his own right. Round eight action.
Come on, get him out.
Action is the operative word.
Duran just will not stop. Those short little punches are very, very effective inside.
Under a half minute left to go in the eighth round, a round in which Duran was hurt early and has survived.
Duran is starting to push his punches a little bit now. But they are landing.
Again, the body work by Barkley. And the uppercut. He's shown us almost every punch in his arsenal tonight. And still, Duran will not fall. Doesn't get better than this.
Keep working. Keep shooting that punch. Shout them up. See, when you duck under, bring them hand high. You try to hit the hook to the head. Duck right under, bring the shoulder up. Upper cut right up on the knee. You're doing great.
Now Golden wants short punches. Here's what he got in the last round.
There you go. He made Duran miss. Came back with that left hook.
And that wasn't a wide left hook. That was a very short punch.
Good snappy move. There he made a miss. And back with that left hook.
How many fighters would have stayed up under that? That's exactly the left hook that knocked Michael Lajide down. And
all right, seconds out.
Helped him get a TKO win over Lajide. There's Roberto Duran. We're headed to the ninth. Many thought it would not go this far.
Let's go. Come on. Let's go. Come on.
Barkley suffered a little bit of a cut over the left eye. He's got some swelling under the left eye, but it hasn't been a major factor.
Couple more more punches, and that eye's going to close, though, Al. And if he blows his nose, for sure it'll close.
Remember, Iran Barkley, who has a propensity to cut, suffered cuts over both eyes in winning the title against Tommy Hearns, and I saw him against Jorge Amparo. He was a bloody mess in that one.
Barkley's starting to dance now a little bit. I think he's trying to coast through around. There's that little dance step. And he's painting with his feet.
He has a right to. He's probably far ahead, wouldn't you agree?
Well, yes, I would have to say that this is a tough fight, and it's a fight that you have to watch because anything can happen. But point-wise, I have Barkley comfortably ahead.
Will the reputation of Roberto Duran mean anything to the judges, though? A question to be asked.
That's what gave me gray hair when I was managing and training fighters. It's not supposed to mean anything.
But then remember the judge who had Sugar Leonard 7 points ahead against Hagler at the end of that fight.
Wasn't that the judge that Hagler's people selected?
Yes, amazingly so. Good right by Duran.
There's not as much snap on Duran's punch now, though.
You're right, he's pushing it more. Halfway through the ninth round, scheduled for 10. Right hand by Barkley, but Duran comes with his own left hook.
I just get the sense somehow that Duran can take a better punch right at this moment in the fight than Iran Barkley. If Duran landed a big clean punch, I think it would have a big effect on Iran. He's tired.
Good work. Good straight right hand. Barkley backs up and takes a right hand. He may be in a little bit of trouble.
But you can see he's really, he's composed, but he's tired, no question. I mean, he should be.
And he goes to the body again. I am amazed that in this ninth round, Duran has taken the body punishment he's taken, and he's still there.
You know, you see these kids fight the amateurs. They fight three rounds, and they train hard, and they get tired. The reason that Duran is able to do what he's doing, he's so relaxed in the ring. He's so comfortable in there.
Half a minute left to go in this ninth round. A strange footnote to this fight is this is only the second time in his long pro career that Roberto Duran has fought in Atlantic City. Alien territory to him, but he's still got his fans, as you've heard throughout this bout.
And they came through the snowstorm to be here.
I bet you they did, to fill this arena. Round nine is ending. Perhaps Duran's best round in the last five or six. What would a Duran fight be without that flag in the crowd? The corner of Roberto Duran is seeking his fourth world title. As you certainly know, he won the lightweight title, the welterweight, and the junior middleweight. He has failed as a middleweight to win the crown. He's behind in the fight, Gil. I think we feel that in any case. Is there enough time for him to turn around a decision?
Don't make no mistake.
I just do not think. I think he's going to have to nail him and really win the round. Believe me, if Duran finished and won these last three rounds comfortably, there'd be a lot of excitement in this hall if he didn't get it.
The left eye of Iran Barkley, a good look at it. As Gil pointed out, it could be ready to close. Little reminiscent of the right eye of Davey Moore when Duran fought him in 83. But the difference here is that Barkley has done much better work in this bout. Is probably ahead, but it could be academic the way they're wailing away.
It almost looks as if Roberto Duran has got a second or third win. Where he got it from, I don't know.
I haven't a clue. With the punishment he's taking from Iran Barkley, both to the body and the head.
Watch for that right hand of Duran's.
When Barkley is lazy with the jab or misses with the hook, that's when the right hand comes across from Duran. We're in the 10th. It is scheduled for 12.
Duran has been landing with the left jab, believe it or not, against the taller guy.
And that was a punch that was dormant early in the fight. But now Duran getting it cranked up.
There's that right hand. And another one on the left hook.
And when he does that, Barkley reverts to his old form and wails away, which makes him even more susceptible to get hit with the counterpunch. It's been a good 10th round for Duran. He cannot be underestimated, even at 37. I guess he's proven that to me.
He's proven to me again that he's one of the greatest fighters that ever lived.
Again, the overhand right in a round in which, like the ninth, Duran has done some excellent work. Good right by Barkley, and there's the jab re-emerging of Iran Barkley. Remember how effective that was over the first 7 or 8 rounds. And every time there's a lull, that chant goes up.
Barkley's legs are starting to spread now.
Duran waited for 3 missed jabs by Duran, by Barkley, and then landed an overhand right. Good right hand on the inside by Duran. It's been a remarkably clean fight from Duran. No headbutting, no elbows. But
big right hand by Duran again.
There have been those. And round 10, a huge round for Duran. Again, the body work of Barkley. Duran. Round 10, a big one for the hands of stone.
You hear me? Come on now, let's go to work. Suck it up. Let's go. You hear me? Let's go. You got to win the next 2 rounds big. You got to get inside, stay inside with this guy.
Put on tape on the glove here. Put on tape on the glove.
A tired Iran Barkley getting some encouragement from Al Bolden. They want him on the inside.
But you know, the thing that amazes me is I thought Duran in about the 7th to 8th round was really starting to show signs of weariness. He came back and fought that last round like it was the first round.
And as we look at Roberto Duran at 37, he has the fans pumped up and he's got himself pumped up. The question, I guess, now is if he doesn't score a knockout, which is not out of the question, can Duran win a decision? 6 more minutes of fighting for this man. Will it be his last 6?
If he fights the 11th and 12th round the way he fought the 10th round, I think it's going to be tough for the judges to vote for Iran Barkley. You know, they like to see a guy finish strong.
Of course, the question is, how many of those early rounds did Barkley take? You have him taking quite a few, but you've got at least 3 or 4 marked close.
3 of them close, which means they could be slide right over into Duran's corner.
I haven't scored it round by round. I would think Barkley's got to be ahead by at least a couple of points, but again, we've got 2 rounds left. Scoring on a 10-point must system. No one has been knocked down in the fight, so presumably these are all 10-9 rounds. But remember, Duran was hurt very badly in the 2nd round, and again in the 8th. Badly hurt in the 8th by a left hook.
Now, Duran threw that right hand with bad intentions. He had about as much snap on that as he's had on any right hand in the earlier round.
Ironically, after he was hurt in the 8th, Duran started his comeback in the 9th round, and in the last 3 has been excellent.
And now Barkley's back to that body again and back up to the head. He can't try to outthink Duran. He has to outbomb him, is what he has to do.
We're in the 11th. It's a 12 rounder and it may go. Good hook downstairs by Barkley and the jab, but nothing is phasing Duran right now.
Except that Barkley is scoring in this round now.
Hasn't been a bad round for Iran. We're halfway through. Who will win the 2nd part of this round?
Is Duran setting to throw that right hand? I can see it from here.
He's looking for the lazy jab of Barkley. They trade hooks.
Showing signs of weariness. No question about that. There's a right hand and a left hook by Duran. And another big right hand by Duran.
Barkley may not be seeing the right hand. And yes, Duran is nailing him with it. They want Barkley on the inside where he isn't going to be hit with that overhand right. Big right by Barkley. But again, the right by Barkley's in trouble. He's down. First knockdown of the fight.
How do you feel?
Alan, you just feel that coming. Just
Barkley
feel it coming.
Up. He's very wobbly. Another right hand by Duran.
Look at Duran go to work. And nice and relaxed. And calm.
Remember, though, Iran Barkley has tremendous heart. He's been down.
Big round, you say 2-point round? That may have been a 3-point.
Very possibly. And we'll see the knockdown.
And you know, you have to remember the 10th could have been a 2-point round. There's that first right hand. There's the left hook, another right hand. And there's the big one, and down he goes. Right on the button.
Combinations from this 37-year-old in the 11th round.
I don't see how Barkley can recover from these shots and come back in this next round. Talk about a surgeon operating on somebody. There's a surgeon for you.
The combination by Duran puts him down. Iran Barkley has his work cut out for him on 12. The 12th and final round. The WBC middleweight crown is at stake, and believe me, it is at stake right now. Barkley, has he shaken the cobwebs?
Well, now it's up to Roberto Duran to have a good finishing round. And as we had mentioned, after the 9th round, if Duran won the last 3 rounds big, that he could get this fight.
And again, the right hand bounces off Barkley's head. Remember, they told Barkley, the longer the fight goes, the better it is for us. It hasn't worked out that way.
Well, we noticed now, remember I mentioned, I said, it looks like Roberto Duran got his 3rd win. Where he got it from, and I just felt he was stronger than Barkley going into those last few rounds.
He said he was in good shape. He looked excellent in his sparring sessions. He came in at a good weight. And yes, Roberto Duran's for real in this bout.
He's still going to have to land another big bomb, Al. He can't think that he has the fight won by any stretch of the imagination.
And interestingly, it's Barkley who's pressing the attack and landing in this round. It has not been a bad beginning in the 12th round for Barkley. This has been a fight of twists and turns.
Well, we have to watch the end of this round. I'm sure Roberto Duran has a good plan for the end of this round.
That's the part he wants to win. He's landing right hands again.
He hurt Barkley again.
Now remember, even if he wins this round, there's no guarantee Duran will win a decision, but he'll be right there.
All right, hit him down there. Come on, work out of there.
Early, Barkley was very effective. Duran started to come back in the middle rounds, especially by the 9th.
Combination by Duran, all 3 punches landed.
What about the heart of Barkley, though, Gil? He was so hurt.
We
here
know.
Here he is in the 12th.
Both these guys have tremendous heart. There's no question about that. When Roberto Duran, those middle rounds looked like he was all out of it. We said the only thing he had left is heart. Boy, somehow he got that second, third win, whatever.
You know, with a minute left, Barkley's still landing good short punches. He landed a great short right hand that drove Duran back. This has not been a bad round for Barkley.
Let's just watch these last 45 seconds, Al.
It'll tell us a lot.
There's that big. Look at Barkley's legs. Doesn't have a leg under him. And look at Duran now. Dancing around, playing.
The jab by Barkley. Can Duran afford to dance around, though? It's been a round that's very close. And the fight may be in the balance with only a little more than 20 seconds left. Barkley with the jab, and that's his best punch right now because he's pushing the hook in the right hand. It'll end, and it will be a classic war. Big right hand by Duran. This has been extraordinary. His left eye is battered. But Iran Barkley thinks he's the winner. So does this man, Roberto Duran.
I wouldn't want to be a judge in this fight, Al.
I wouldn't either. I would give the nod personally to Barkley. I thought he probably won more rounds, even with a 2 or 3 point round by Duran. But it would be a very, very close call. Whatever, you could see this man, Roberto Duran, is proud of his effort, and he should be.
And you know, Al, that knockdown is such a big, big point in this fight. It could make all the difference in the world.
It will depend greatly on whether that was a 2 or 3 point round. Again, the judges in this fight, Tommy Kaczmarek from the U.S., from New Jersey here, Giuseppe Ferrari from Italy, and Dave Brown from Canada. Iran Barkley and Stan Hoffman from the Houston Boxing Association. You have to take your hat off to Barkley. Nothing comes easy to this man, and hey, you win the bet, buddy. They're hugging at the end, Bill.
Well, that's the way it goes, fellas. Fighters gain respect for each other during a fight. Believe me.
And if these two gentlemen didn't gain respect, no one ever will during a boxing match. Well, in truth, some denigrated this match. They felt it would be a mismatch for Barkley. Didn't turn out to be that way.
Well, I just did not believe that Roberto could do it.
You think they could fit anybody else in that ring? Early on, Iran Barkley hurting Roberto Duran. Good left hand, and that was in the eighth round. And boy, oh boy, how could Duran come back from that? And yet, come back he did. Here's the 11th.
Now let's just watch the surgeon operate again. There's the first right hand. There's the left hook. There's the other right hand. And the final coup de grace.
Was that the moment that could have tilted it for Roberto Duran? It's the question we have to ask ourselves. And Michael Buffer's in that mess somewhere. I don't know if he has a decision. We're waiting to find out. God knows how we'd see him even if he did have the decision. Iran Barkley feeling very much that he won this fight. He has a strong case, but so does Roberto Duran. We'll get it now. Here it is. There's Michael Buffer. We can get the decision from him. There is a problem with the microphone. All the people in the ring may have pulled it out. That's a first. Well, it may not be a first, but I haven't seen it. And so Michael Buffer looking for a new mic. Here it is.
Ladies and gentlemen.
You're on, Michael.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. Your attention, please. Can you hear that? Test. Ladies and gentlemen. Test.
Well, there's Iran Barkley, the drama building here, because Michael Buffer can't seem to get his microphone working, or they can't get it working for him. Iran Barkley looking, he's got the damaged left eye. He looks for all the world like he absorbed big punishment, but he gave out a lot to Roberto Duran.
Well, you know, again, it's the question of the one guy working in three minutes, the other guy throwing beautiful combinations, taking advantage of every opportunity. Whether Duran gets this decision or not, he has gained my respect as one of the greatest fighters that ever lived. No question about it, and he may get the decision.
As well he should, and it's bound to be a close one any way you look at it. Probably a split decision. We're still waiting for Michael Buffer to be able to give us the decision. The ring is filled with people. A recap, Roberto Duran hurt in the eighth round, hurt in the second, but coming back to knock Barkley down in the 11th and having a very big finish in the last four rounds.
You know, Al, we just sensed that he seemed stronger physically in those latter rounds than Iran Barkley. You could just see it in that ring.
Are you shocked that the latter part of the fight where Barkley and his people thought they would win, are you shocked that Duran was able to do that at the end?
There's no question about it. You know, the thing that got me, I said it may wind up being who was the better catcher. And I felt that Barkley was vulnerable to get nailed.
Here's an example of what you're talking about, is the two men show that mutual respect you talked about, Gil. Who could catch better? Duran caught first.
To get in the ring.
Here's that slip by Barkley, the big left hook. Spun Duran around, but he just did not go down. He's such a sturdy little guy with those strong legs that he has.
But Barkley would go down.
There's the first right hand. There's the left hook. There's the right hand. And bam. That would put anybody down.
I should think so.
Wasn't one punch. It was four clean punches all on the button.
And Barkley got up and fought a fairly decent 12th round. But was it enough? We'll get it now. Here it comes, the decision. Well, we thought it was coming.
Quiet, please! Quiet, please! Quiet, please!
Michael Buffer's in the center of the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a split decision. Dave Brown scores the bout 116 to 113 for Barkley.
Iran Barkley, 116-113.
Giuseppe Ferrari scores it 118-112 for Duran.
Oh, what a big display.
Wow.
Tommy Kaczmarek scores it 116-112 for the winner and new.
That tells you who's champion. A wild discrepancy on the scorecard. 118-112 for Duran is shocking, as is 116-112 for Duran.
Well, apparently they were captured by Duran's ring generalship, the fact that he threw those flashy little combinations, and they forgot about Barkley's work ethic.
Well, it is a split decision win for Roberto Duran. He's won his fourth world title. Let's go up to Tony Hernandez. He has both fighters.
Roberto Duran. Roberto Duran, the new World Boxing Council middleweight champion. Your name, sir?
My name is Luis de Cubas.
Okay, Luis is our interpreter. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
He was in trouble in the seventh and eighth, real bad. Uh-huh. How was he able to come back? Ask him.
Roberto, él dice que en el 7 y el 8 parece que estabas lastimado. ¿Cómo pudiste regresar?
Él me metió una trompa, pero no me hizo mucho daño porque yo estaba en muy buenas condiciones.
He said he hit him in the seventh and eighth with good shots, but he really wasn't hurt because he's in terrific shape.
Roberto, to wait here, Iran Barkley. Iran, it was a great fight, Iran. Your left hook was very effective. What happened in the last part of the fight that got you in trouble?
Well, I felt I was winning the fight. Roberto is a legend, you know, so quite naturally I could figure that they do that. But it was a good fight, you know, and the best man won. That's the way the judges called it. That's the way they see it. I got to take my hat off to the man. He's a good man.
Strong, you're strong, very strong for me. You're heavy.
You guys like each other after all.
Hey, you know, he's a tough man, you know.
You're seeing this, ladies and gentlemen, embraced by Roberto Duran and Iran Barkley. Roberto, Luis, Roberto, what is next? Is he going to keep fighting now that he has the title? Does he want Leonard again?
¿Qué es lo próximo? ¿Quién es a Sugar Ray Leonard?
Cuando yo peleé con Sugar Ray Leonard, si Dios quiere, yo voy a estar en mejores condiciones porque tenía tiempo que no peleaba.
He says next time he fights Sugar Ray Leonard, he's going to be in a lot better shape in this fight because he's had a long time layoff, and he wasn't yet up to key. He's going to be for key for Leonard. He's going to be right this time.
Roberto, su corazón es increíble. ¿De dónde viene su deseo?
Panama City, Republic of Panama. I love you, Panama. I like you, Miami. I like you, United States.
Luis, he says, of course, that his desire, his heart, comes from his homeland of Panama City.
That's right. That's
one of the great fighters of all time, ladies and gentlemen. One of the great warriors. The new WBC middleweight champion, Roberto Duran, in a classic evening of boxing here in Atlantic City. Al, back to you.
Well, Roberto Duran wins his fourth world title. Iran Barkley very gracious in defeat, perhaps more gracious than I would expect, Gil, with the scoring being 118-112, 116-112 against him, when one judge had it 116-113 for Barkley. And of course, it was the knockdown, really, that probably turned the tide.
You know, we always say that they're supposed to score every round and put it in the bank.
Yeah.
You got to finish strong. And did Duran finish strong? I mean, that was just such a beautiful knockdown. Al, I think that was a three-point round.
Probably was. And that is probably what turned that fight so dramatically in the scoring for Roberto Duran. He wins the fourth title. Honestly, coming into tonight, did you think he could do it?
We saw a miracle tonight, Al.
It really was.
It was a miracle. I mean, he fought a well-conditioned, big, strong guy that worked 3 minutes of every round. You figure a 37-year-old guy, how could he keep up that pace? And Barkley kept banging to the body, banging to the body. And, you know, the old saying in boxing, bang to the body, the head will die. Nothing on Roberto Duran died, especially his heart.